Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Some ores can be broken apart by the process of decrepitation. If you have a combination of a crystalline material and an amorphous material, or of two crystalline materials that you can roast to the crackling or shattering point decrepitate. At different temperatures, and you heat them to the lower of the two decrepitation temperatures, you can create a condition in which separation is simple. Take, for example, an ore of zinc sulfate in combination with barite. When heated, the crystalline zinc sulfate will decrepitate into fine particles, while the barite remains solid, making separation a simple screening operation. This method can also be used to separate small particles of gold trapped or encapsulated in small quartz particles. If heated sufficiently on a steel plate or under a blowpipe, the quartz will decrepitate, freeing the values. Decrepitation is caused by the expansion of the chemically combined water of hydration in the crystals as it vaporizes. Concentration, the next step, is a final separating or concentrating operation. The object is to free the values from any remaining gang. In secondary separation, unwanted material is not commonly called gang because it frequently has value itself, but relative to the more precious material being isolated, that is what it is. For example, if you have a piece of sterling silver, which is an alloy of copper and silver, and you want to free the copper becomes the gang. In most cases, the final separation or concentration is not entirely pure but is sufficient to make the next step, that of reduction or refining, possible. Separation and concentration operations, whether wet or dry, are usually based on the difference in specific gravity of the value versus the gang. Magnetic material can be separated by magnetic separators. The two simplest methods of concentrating values based on differences in specific gravity are panning gold and working dry placers or river beds with a blanket. Gold has a specific gravity of 19.32. Silica is quartz, a specific gravity of 2.65. Black sand magnetite Fe34, a specific gravity of 5.18. And flint, a specific gravity of 2.6, gold is therefore 7.29 times heavier than quartz or flint and 3.73 times heavier than magnetite. If a mixture of these four materials is panned correctly, the gold, being heavier, will stay behind as first the materials with a 2.6 specific gravity, and then the black sands are floated off. A common practice with old-timers was to place roughly equal-sized material, as determined by a sieve, on a blanket and then pop it up into the air, letting the wind take off the light materials in exactly the same manner as chaff used to be winnowed from grain. Further concentration was accomplished by spreading out the gold and blowing lightly over it, orally or with a bellows. The dry sluice apparatus consists of a sluice with wooden riffles on a porous canvas deck. As the material makes its way downward, the mechanism that shakes the sluice also operates a bellows from below, which puffs intermittent blasts of air up through the canvas to the material. These blasts of air carry away the light material. Some bellows are single-stage puffers, whereas others are double-stage and supply a continuous current of air. There are innumerable types of final stage classifiers and concentrators. Elutriation is the washing, separating, or sizing of fine particles of different weights by suspending them in a current of air or liquid, usually water. Some elutriating devices are the gold pan, the sluice, the rocker, the rug sluice, the gold spiral wheel, the spiral trommel, the Humphreys spiral, the jig, the vortex cyclone, the vertical flow trap, and the log washer. To use a gold pan, fill the pan with gravel and place the pan. We return to the topic of our video today. After crushing the stone, it is roasted well. Place the roasted raw material in a bowl and add aqua regia to it. After that, we filter. Then add a little water and urea. After that, add iron sulfate with a little water. Iron sulfate, specifically ferrous sulfate fesos, is often used in the process of precipitating gold from a solution. It works effectively to reduce gold ions O cubed to metallic gold, which then precipitates out of the solution. This method is commonly used in gold refining and recovery processes because it is cost-effective and efficient. However, the choice of precipitant can depend on various factors, including the concentration of gold in the solution and the specific conditions of the process. When you precipitate gold from an aqua regia solution using iron sulfate feces, the gold is reduced and comes out of the solution as a fine gold powder or dust. The gold will precipitate out of the solution as fine particles, which appear as a brownish or reddish-brown dust. Allow the gold to settle to the bottom of the container. Carefully decant the liquid above the gold dust without disturbing it. Wash the gold dust with distilled water to remove any remaining chemicals. After the washing process, the gold dust can be dried carefully, usually in a low heat environment, to avoid any loss. The gold powder obtained can then be further purified or melted down to form a solid piece of gold. Always remember that working with chemicals like aqua regia is hazardous and proper safety measures should be followed. Smelting gold dust with flux is a process used to refine gold by removing impurities and obtaining pure, molten gold. The process involves melting the gold dust along with a combination of chemicals known as flux, which helps to separate the metal from impurities like oxides and other non-metallic materials. Here's a detailed guide on the process. Preparation: gather materials, gold dust, the fine particles of gold that you want to smelt. Flux, a combination of chemicals that will help to purify the gold. Common flux materials include borax sodium tetrabrate, lowers the melting point of the metal and helps to dissolve oxides. Soda ash sodium carbonate, helps remove impurities. Silica sand, combines with metal oxides to form slag, which floats on top of the molten metal. Litharge lead oxide, sometimes used in small quantities to absorb non-gold metals. The amount of flux needed depends on the quantity of gold dust and the nature of the impurities present. A common starting ratio might be cologne.borax, 5 parts soda ash, 3 parts silica, 1 part. These ratios can be adjusted based on experience or specific impurity levels in the gold dust. When you smelt gold dust with flux, you obtain purified gold. The flux, typically a combination of chemicals like borax and sodium carbonate, helps to remove impurities from the gold during the smelting process. The end result is usually molten gold, which can then be cooled and solidified into gold bars or other forms. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. Thanks for watching.